Assalamu alaikum friends. Welcome to my new video. In this video, I am going to discuss new research ideas that can be used for undergraduate final year project, master degree research, or one of the PhD research objectives. Friends, just think of any power system. Suppose for your convenience, I am considering the IEEE 9 bus test system as shown here. Now, this power system may be subjected to different types of faults, such as symmetrical faults as well as unsymmetrical faults, as shown here. These faults may occur at any bus or line. Now, suppose we want to propose a technique that can be used to automatically detect these faults as well as classify all these faults. Friends, by detection means technique is capable of distinguishing between normal condition and faulty condition in the power system. Whereas by classification means the technique is capable of distinguishing between different types of faults. It means that it can distinguish in which phase fault is occurred and in which phase fault is not occurred. Friends, before sharing with you how and by which techniques this power system fault identification and classification in the transmission system as well as distribution system can be carried out, let's consider another situation in the same power system. We know that power system is subjected to various transients and harmonics due to switching, load variation, and many other reasons. These transient disturbances can cause various power quality problems as shown here. Now suppose we want to propose a technique that can be used to automatically identify and classify these power quality disturbances. It means that it can distinguish power system has encountered which quality disturbance and how it can be mitigated. Friends, at this stage, we have discussed two main issues of the power system known as identification and classification of various types of faults and power quality disturbances in power system. Now, question may arise that how we can identify and classify these faults or power quality disturbances in the power system. The answer to this question is that in most of the cases, signal processing techniques are commonly used to extract the features of the voltage or current signals. Based upon this extraction, faults or power quality disturbances can be identified and classified. These signal processing techniques may include Fourier transform, fast Fourier transform, discrete Fourier transform, wavelet transform, discrete wavelet transform, S-transform, multi-resolution analysis, or any other new signal processing technique. Friends, based upon this power system, faults classification, power quality disturbances, and signal processing techniques, following various research titles can be considered for your research. The signal processing techniques have the ability to identify and classify the faults or power quality disturbances. However, these techniques suffer from the threshold limitations. Therefore, their accuracy may be affected and they are system dependent. It means that when power system size or voltage levels are changed, then we have to determine again another new threshold value which can be used to distinguish between faults or power quality disturbances. To overcome the limitations of threshold values, computational intelligence-based techniques are commonly used with signal processing techniques. Such as artificial neural network can be used as a classifier to identify and classify the faults or power quality disturbances. Friends, I have already made the videos on artificial neural network series to understand its basic with the title How to Implement Artificial Neural Network in MATLAB Simulink Software. This ANN series consists of 4 parts. Therefore, you may watch this video series if you want to apply artificial neural network on this matter. Furthermore, artificial neural network also has many types, such as radial basis function neural network, or probabilistic neural network, or wavelet neural network, convolution neural network, support vector machine, deep learning, and its various types. You may also use the combination of artificial neural network and fuzzy logic controller, namely adaptive neurofuzzy inference system. Friends, I have already made the videos on adaptive neurofuzzy inference system series to understand its basic with the title How to Implement Adaptive Neurofuzzy Inference System in MATLAB Simulink. This M.phil series consists of two parts. Therefore, you may watch this video series if you want to apply M.phil controller on this model. Based upon this power system, faults, classification, power quality, disturbances, and intelligent techniques, following various research titles can be considered for your research. Friends, these topics are so important that still many researchers are doing their PhDs in power system fault identification and classification, as well as power quality disturbances classification. In this video, I have discussed only two topics from which various different research titles can be obtained to complete your bachelor degree final year project, master research, or your PhD research. That's all for today's video. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends, so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.